Welcome, friends. It's Sunday morning, so we're going to do another one of the post-Depression pre-World War II recipes out of my favorite recipe, published by the Stainer Sun, about 1938. And today we're going to make something called a date sandwich. Now, Julie and I constantly laugh about the recipes in this book because they all contain dates. There doesn't seem to be very many sort of dessert recipes that don't have them. So I thought I'd make one that was full on. This is a date recipe. So into this pot, I have water, brown sugar, and chopped dates. And date sandwich, most of us would probably know this as simply date squares. So I'm gonna put in butter as well. And we're just gonna bring this to a boil and boil it for about a minute or a minute and a half, just to soften the dates and get the water to thicken a little bit with the sugar. Now, to me, this is a classic mid-Ontario recipe. One of my grandmothers made it all the time. And so I'm gonna let you in on a little bit of a secret. I made this recipe, I shot this video a couple of days ago, and at the end, Julie and I commented that it didn't seem quite right. We didn't think that the recipe tasted right, the crust wasn't right, and I got through the edit and started writing out the recipe and putting in things that I would change to make it better, to make it more the classic date square recipe. And it turns out I had misread the recipe in this book completely, absolutely completely. And part of the reason for that is this recipe is written as a paragraph or as a story, and there isn't a list of ingredients, and I had missed an ingredient. So in this food processor, I've put flour, baking soda, and brown sugar. And brown sugar is something that I missed the first time. You really have to put it in the crust. I'm putting in some very cold butter. I had it in the freezer. You don't necessarily have to keep it in the freezer. You could take it right out of the fridge and use it. And these are rolled oats, and they're not quick oats. They're actually, you know, large flake rolled oats. I'm gonna use a food processor. I know that's cheating. 1938, they didn't have one. They would have put it together with a pastry knife or rubbed it with their fingers. I'm gonna use a food processor. Okay, this looks good. This is boiling pretty well, so I'm gonna pull it off the heat and just gonna let it cool down, not completely to room temperature, just enough that I can put the vanilla in. So I'm gonna move on to the crust. Now we take about half of this mixture, put it into the bottom of a 9x9 pan, about half, it doesn't have to be exact, and we just wanna press it into the pan. You can use your hand, you can use the back of a glass, you could use a wooden spoon, whatever makes you happy. And you do want to pack in this base nice and tight. Okay, that's good. Now, the recipe doesn't say how much vanilla. I'm going to say maybe 2 teaspoons worth of vanilla for this much date mixture. And I'm just going to stir that in. Can you have too much vanilla? I don't think so. I've never reached a point where I've had too much vanilla in a dish. Okay, so we're gonna pour this over top. And then just spread it out. So this date mixture is already pretty thick from the boiling process. It looks great, it smells even better. Tastes really good too. Now, the rest of the oat mixture goes on top, and we spread this on, but you don't need to pack it in nearly as tightly. And if you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by. Glad to see you. And we always put the recipe both at the end of the video and in the description box below on YouTube. So you can find the full recipe, all the ingredients, the method, everything will be there. So we just press this in. And you can't pack it too tightly because your hand will go right into the date mixture. Now it says to bake this in a moderate oven. So here we go.
So Glen, did he tell you that he already made this once?
I fessed up, yes. I did fess up.
So this one does appear to be much better.
Yes, definitely much better. Apparently sugar-free. Well, it sounds like it might be a little bit healthier. Probably not what you're looking for. Now, this is still pretty warm. But
it is still pretty warm. You're willing to give it a go.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So that is the classic date square taste that, you know, was on every sideboard for every family gathering, right?
I clearly should have cut the pieces smaller.
Mm-hmm. They are really sweet.
But as we know, dates are a popular thing, especially in rural...
Rural Middle Ontario.
Middle Ontario in the 1930s.
Now, in other cookbooks where I see this recipe from the 50s and 60s, they say 9x9 pan, and they say to cut it into 36 pieces. So that kind of gives you an idea of
how... That was one.
Yeah.
I mean, I just ate a whole piece.
Well, that's it. I mean, they're saying 36 pieces because they are incredibly sweet, and it's something that you're just supposed to have a tiny little bit of every once in a while. This is not what we would normally do, you know, a pan like this. If it was a cake, cut it into 6 or 8 pieces. And.
But if it was a cake, you would?
Yeah, probably. Probably. So.
The fun thing about this, though,
mm-hmm.
is that you could modify this recipe with a lot of other fruits in the middle.
A whole pile of different dried fruits.
So, you know, anything from apricots to...
dried apples probably would work in the middle of this.
So whatever fruits are available to you.
Yes. Figs.
Yeah.
I think
create a filling. And
figs would be amazing.
Oats, butter, sugar.
Yeah.
You're good to go.
Yeah, so you're right. Any dried fruit would work in this. Give it a try. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.
Take care.